I would now like to invite UNESCO Chairholder Professor Dr. Vishwanath Dikarad, Founder President MIT World Peace University, Founder Executive President MAEER's MIT Group of Institutions for his presidential address. Please put your hands together and welcome with a big round of applause Professor Dr. Vishwanath Dikarad.
Friends, what a good fortune for all of us that today, just a day before the 12th January, the birthday of the great Noble Son of India, Swami Vivekananda, we have such learned scholars, thinkers, and philosophers on this dais. The very learned teachers, I will say, philosophers, and those who have lived their life with an appropriate understanding of the role of science and spiritual component of life. Bharatiya Sanskriti, Bharatiya Parampara ka vishay hai. Adhyatma ka matlab janne ka prayas hai. Abhi aapne आदरणीय लोकेश मुनि जी को सुना, जिनका मन, जिनकी भावना, जिनकी सोच विचार, प्रमोटिंग द कल्चर ऑफ पीस इन द वर्ल्ड एंड डेवलपिंग द होलिस्टिक सोसाइटी, ऑनरेबल जस्टिस हेगड़े जी, अनिरुद्ध देशपांडे जी, माय एस्टीम फ्रेंड Scott Harriet from America, Maharshi Vidyapeet, और हमारे भाई कलबे रिजवी सिद्दीकी, what a good fortune. I see a number of them sitting in front of me. I can only say that if you just closely observe the very theme of this conference, this deliberation, it is said value-based universal education system. I'd like to just make a mention to you, friends, being a student of engineering, having some little understanding of the particle physics, IT, computer, and at the same time having an ideal, a great mission, and the words of wisdom the great Noble Son of India had spoken in 1893. I have said the same thing to you yesterday, but I'd like to repeat this sentence once again. Unfortunately, in my life, that became the life mission. When I was to go for engineering, I don't know how, but that shopkeeper where I had gone to purchase a book of mathematics, he just gave me the book on Swami Vivekananda. And the same sentence which I repeat again, friends, that one sentence spoken by this great Noble Son of India in 1893, sochne ki koshish karo. And he says to the world parliament of religions, all the great thinkers, philosophers, scientists, men of religion and men of philosophy present in the audience, and he says the first sentence, of course that word you know it very well, my brothers and sisters of America and the whole world. He makes an appeal and tells them to remember that very sentence which is so dear to our heart, union of science and religion / spirituality will help to bring harmony and peace to mankind and will certainly help to develop the holistic global society. Sandesh hai ye, sari duniya ke liye hai, Hindu ke liye nahi, Islam ke sirf nahi. लेकिन शाति सारी जाति धर्म के लोगों को रिलीजन की व्याख्या बताई थी. ही सेड टू द वर्ल्ड कम्युनिटी, फ्रेंड्स रिमेंबर, रिलीजन इज नथिंग बट टू परफॉर्म वंस ड्यूटी. अपना फर्ज क्या है? द ड्यूटी टुवर्ड द मदर, ड्यूटी टुवर्ड द फादर, द फैमिली, द सोसाइटी and the nation and the whole world, Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, one word. He had conveyed the appropriate meaning of the words like I told you yesterday, Aham Brahmasmi, Tattvamasi, Oham, who am I? Soham, Nahi Jnanena Sadrusham Pavitramiha Vidyate. Yes, Sare Shabd, all these words, they look like religious words. But friends, being an engineer, I can make an appeal to you that none of these words, so short and so brief, they speak about the principles and laws of nature and life. Yes, scientific principles hai bhai. Ye koi kisi dharmik sandesh nahi. Ye to swayam dharm ka sandesh hai. What is the duty as a teacher? To my mind, friends, I feel that when I have said this word universal, every nation has its own geography, its own history, its own culture, its own traditions. But remember, the time-tested values are common. It plays with the nature, the law of nature, law of universe. And let me tell you honestly, it is said that the law of any nation or any country or for the law of the teachers themselves is about the character building. Finally, when you are meant to perform your duty, kya farz hai bhai tumhara aur mera? Aapka swayam ka jeevan, abhi Lokesh Muni ji ke saath sare log yahan pe Hegde ji hai, baki hamare Scott Harriet hai, Kalbe ji hai, Deshpande ji hai, ye sare logon ke jeevan ki taraf dekho. Unka jeevan janne ki koshish karo. You please try to understand, they have a different personality, a winning personality jise bola jata hai. They are physically fit, mentally alert, intellectually sharp, but spiritually elevated. The last word is the most important word. And they are the men of character, men of discipline, men of decency, decorum, and dignity in life. Ye sare shabdon ka khel nahi. Main apne dil se, man se bol raha hoon. Mujhe bahut khushi hai ki jis Vivekanand ke naam pe ye sansa chalti hai, Sant Gyaneshwar aur Sant Tukaram ki baat hoti hai, Guru Nanak ho, Kanak Das ho, Purandas ho, Namdev ho, ye sare symbolic hai. But vaise is Saint Francis of Assisi too. Remember, all the saints and sages of the whole world giving a certain message for promoting this culture of peace has been the mission, and education is the tool. And we are the men, we are the instruments to really convey the appropriate meaning of this role of science and spiritual command of life to the new generation. Sari duniya ki baat hai, sari desh ki baat hai. Main itna kahunga, mujhe bahut khushi hai aaj, visheshkar ki aadarniya Lokesh Muni ji aur meri mulaqat hui thi Salt Lake City mein. Pata nahi mera dost kahan baitha hai, Ashok Doshi, because of whom I had the fortune of visiting America for the 9th Parliament of Religions. I had the fortune of organizing the first parliament here in this campus, called as a Parliament of Science, Religion and Philosophy. Baat nahi karte hai na. Hamare jaise scientists, technocrats, they sit in their ivory towers, aur shayad baki logon ko ye to dharmik hai, ye adhyatmik hai. Adhyatma ka matlab kai neta log to andhashraddha bolte hai. Kya kahe bhai? Main itna hi kahunga ki in this conference, I was asked to speak on this very same subject. Whether the Indian value-based universal education system, Indian, they said, can help to minimize the chaos, confusion, bloodshed, massacre, and terrorism, and violence in the whole world. That was the subject. But I will not say much, but I said, now the time has come. If the 21st century is going to be the century for this land, Mother India, then possibly you may have to think tens of times what the words of wisdom have been spoken by the great saints and sages and seers of India and the world. And finally, I said, follow the principles and the advice given by the great noble son again, Swami Vivekananda, in which I concluded my speech, and I would like to repeat, especially when Lokesh ji is here, to bless and show the pathway Honorable Minister Saab, who has spoken so wonderfully well as a politician, as a leader. He is speaking the vision of Mother India, possibly under the guidance of Honorable Narendra Modi ji, which has been again destined possibly to take the pathway in an appropriate manner. Main itna hi kahunga. When I concluded my speech in Salt Lake City, I would like to repeat it here. I said to those friends, friends, we are the birds of the same nest. We may speak, we may wear different skins, we may speak different tongues, we may believe in different religions, we may belong to different cultures, yet we share the same home, the Mother Earth. Friends, born on the same planet, covered by the same skies, gazing at the same stars, breathing the same air, we must learn to progress together or miserably perish together. For a person can live individually, but can only live and survive collectively. Niche likha hai Atharva Veda. Normally, the moment I utter the word Veda or any scriptures like the Bhagavad Gita, Bible, Holy Quran, Tripitak, Guru Granth Sahib, naam le lo, ye sare dharm granth ka matlab hai, ye to jeevan granth hai bhai. They are the scriptures which teach us how to live and how not to live. Ye dono baatein hai. You must know how to really survive and let the others survive. Isi sandesh ke saath jab Atharvaved ka quotation hua, mujhe yaad hai, Swami ji yahan par hai, Muni ji, 80 nations, 10,000 delegates from the whole world. The moment I uttered this word Atharva Veda, entire audience stood up for a minute or two and a big appreciation and a clapping for these words of wisdom spoken from Atharva Veda. So let us not have a misunderstanding that science is totally different and the spiritual component, the religious component is something different. Ye bahut badi purani baat hai. Especially this India has been misled by those great people, Britishers, who ruled this country. And they have said that let these people, having the understanding of the Vedic literature, the Vedic sciences, forget the real value-based universal education system. Tyag aur samarpan, ye do shabd hai, bolna theek hai ki nahi pata nahi, lekin Muni ji, aapke jeevan ke liye, aapka jeevan aapne samarpit kiya hai. Tyag aur samarpan ki bhavna hai. Aur khoj hai antim satya ki, hamare sant Gyaneshwar ji ne kaha, 16 saal ki umar hai, phir se bataunga, sochne jaisi baat hai ye. At the age of only 16, a boy is telling and writing a commentary on Bhagavad Gita in Marathi, Gyaneshwari, where he says, Om Namo Jayadya, Veda Pratipadya, Jaya Jaya Swasamvedya Atmarupa. Unhone kaha, he says, I'm writing this scripture called Gyaneshwari, a commentary on Bhagavad Gita, to understand the ultimate reality, the ultimate truth. Aur wahi bhasha, baad mein Einstein ne kaha hai, now I realize, at the end of his life giving equation like equal to mc squared, he says, now I realize that the entire universe is a manifestation of pure intelligence and pure consciousness. Wahi bhasha hai, Einstein ki, 730 saal ke baad, yahi samajhne ki koshish hai. Dhanyawad.
Thank you, Professor Dr. Vishwanath D. Karad.